this people came here, they got two little girls, and every service when I put my hand out to the camera, I said, just put your hand on your television screen, I will pray for you now. So they will always put their hands there. So as I was preaching, this one little girl just walked up. They're here in the church now tonight. So the one little girl went and touched the screen, you know, and the other one said, let's go play. Uncle Quibus is healed. You don't have to pray for him now. It's good. If you don't change and become like little children, you will never enter the kingdom. Okay, John chapter 8. This is God's holy word, everybody. Inspired by the Holy Spirit. That same anointing is upon me tonight. To see, hear, and receive. Spirit of knowing, seeing, and hearing is very vibrant in the house. The man of God preaches with power. The word is going out with strength, purity, and anointing in Jesus' name. All right, John chapter 8, verse 30. As he said these things, we're going to read a long portion. Many believed in him, trusted, relied on, and adhered to him. So Jesus said to those Jews who had believed in him. Everybody says, this is Jews that believed. So this is not the stubborn Pharisees. This is people that now believe he is the Christ. He said to those that believed in him. And Jesus said to those Jews who believed in him, if you abide in my word, you are truly my disciples. And you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. They, the believing Jews, answered him, we are Abram's offspring and have never been in bondage to anybody. What do you mean by saying you will be set free? The believing Jews. Jesus answered them, I assure you most solemnly, I tell you, whoever commits and practices sin is the slave of sin. Now we know believing not in Jesus is sin. Now a slave does not remain in a household permanently. The son does remain forever. So you can choose if you want to be a servant or a son. You got that. So if the son liberates you. Everybody say liberates. I think the King James would just say set you free. So if the son liberates you, then you are really and unquestionably free. Yes, I know that you are Abram's offspring, yet you plan to kill me, the believing Jews. Because my word has no entrance, makes no progress, does not find any place in you. Jump back. Jesus said to the believing Jews, if you keep my word, if you abide in my word, if you stay in my word, you will know the truth and the truth shall set you free. So Jesus said to them, you plan to kill me because my word has no entrance, makes no progress, does not find any place in you. I tell the things which I have seen and learned at my father's side, and your actions also reflect what you have heard and learned from your father. They retorted. Means they pull their faces. Abram is our father. Nobody got that, just one. Jesus said, if you were truly Abram's children, then you would do the works of Abram. Follow his example and do as Abram did. But now instead you are wanting and seeking to kill me, the believing Jews. A man who has told you the truth which I have heard from God, this is not the way Abram acted. You are doing the works of your father. They said to him, we are not illegitimate children and born out of fornication. We have one father, even God. Jesus said to them, the believing Jews, if God were your father, you would love me and respect me and welcome me gladly. For I proceeded from God, and I didn't even come on my own authority or my own accord, but he sent me. Why do you misunderstand what I say? King James would say, why can't you not hear my word? Is that right? It is because you are unable to hear what I'm saying. You cannot bear to listen to my message. Your ears are shut to my teaching. You are of your father the devil, the believing Jews. And it is your will to practice the lust and gratify the desires which are characteristic of your father. He was a murderer from the beginning and does not stand in the truth because there is no truth in him. But if you keep my word, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. When he speaks a falsehood, he speaks what is natural to him, for he is a liar and a father of liars and all that is false. But because I speak the truth, you do not believe me. You do not trust me. You do not rely on me. You do not adhere to me. Who of you convicts me of wrongdoing or finds me guilty of sin? Then if I speak the truth, why do you not believe me? The believing Jews. Whoever is of God listens to God. Those who belong to God hear the words of God. This is the reason that you do not listen to the words to me, because you do not belong to God and are not of God or in harmony with him. The Jews answered him, are we not right when we say you are a Samaritan and that you have a demon? That you are under the power of an evil spirit? Jesus answered, I'm not possessed by a demon. On the contrary, I honor and reverence my Father, and you dishonor me. However, I am not in search of honor for myself. I seek not and aim not at anything of my own glory. There is one that seeks my glory, and he is the judge. I assure you most solemnly, I tell you, if anyone observes my teaching, live in accordance with my message, keep my words, he will by no means ever see and experience death. The Jews said to him, now we know that you are under the power of a demon. You are insane, man. Abram died and also the prophets, yet you say if a man keeps my word, he will never taste of death into all eternity. Are you greater than our father Abram? He died and all the prophets died. Who are you and who make yourself out to be? Jesus answered, if I were to glorify myself, I would have no real glory, for my glory would be nothing and worthless. It is my Father who glorifies me, extols, magnifies, and praises me, of whom you say that he is your God. Yet you do not know him or recognize him and not acquainted with him, but I know him. If I should say that I do not know him, I would be a liar like you. But I know him and keep his word. Your forefather Abram was extremely happy at the hope and prospect of seeing my day, and he did see it and was delighted. Then the Jews said to him, you are not 50 years old, and have you seen Abram? Jesus replied, I assure you, most solemnly, I tell you, before Abram was born, I am. So they took up stones to throw at him, but Jesus, mixed with the crowd, concealed himself and went out into the temple disclosure. How would you like to sit under Jesus' teaching? Little Jesus, meek and mild, Lamb of God. How would you like to sit in his teaching? You are of your father, the devil. You vipers, you snakes. Huh? Jesus says, there is liberty. You will be liberated. You will be set free. There is freedom. He says, this freedom and this liberty come if you will keep my word. He says, but because my word has no entrance in you, you're going to just die in your sin. Because my word has no entrance in you, it proves that you are of your father, the devil. But if you allow my word to have entrance, find a place in you, and then abide in you, you will know truth. And that truth that you know because my word is in you will set you free, and you shall be free indeed. You will be liberated. Now, church, I'm not funny, but there's very few liberated people that I know that is really free to preach, free to sing, free to be happy, free to love Jesus, free to just believe God's word. People sit and they forever doubting. I mean, talk about Thomas, talk about preachers. Huh? Sit here and you get 25 scriptures in one message saying the same thing, and you say, I'm first going to check it out. Jesus said, you know who's your father? But this can't be true. But we've read 25 scriptures in consequence, right after another, one after the other, saying, you shall not die, you shall not die, you shall say, no, I don't think we can not die, I think we must die. So Jesus said, that's not freedom, that's bondage. Are you free if you're forever doubting and forever questioning? Are you free? No, man, your brain is so tied down and so bound, you know, you can't even be free to just be happy. If people laugh, you get upset. Huh? I'm just talking about, don't you think it's time to be liberated? Don't you think it's time to be totally free? So Jesus tells us exactly how we can experience total liberation and total freedom by the word. Okay? Now, if we back up a little, I think we mentioned the scripture twice already this week. When Jesus spoke to the disciples, he said to them, the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. He's talking about him being the bread of life. If you eat my flesh and drink my blood, you shall live and never die. Yeah. And the disciples started departing. They said, this is a tough word, man. Who can eat his flesh? And Jesus said, do you want to depart? Remember, I think I said it last night. Peter said, where shall we go? With you are the words of life. So Jesus says, if you abide in my word, stay in my word, you shall be totally free and totally liberated. Because this word that I speak is spirit. And it is life. Now, you would be stupid to refuse life-giving spirit, that is word, to enter into your life. That's why if I read my Bible, I said it in the February conference, I put a lot of stress on it, I will not read a Bible without a pen. I refuse. If I come in this church and I think, oh, I want to read Bible, and I found a Bible, I don't care whose Bible it is, so don't leave your Bible in the church. You're going to get it back full of lines and stripes and stars and marks. Ask the people that pick up their Bibles here. If I walk around you at night and I pray, oh, there's a Bible. The first thing I look for is a pen. Because God's going to speak to me. It's not a Bible. God's now going to speak. So the first thing I look for is a pen, because there's always pens lying around you. Pen, pen, pen. And I got a pen and I just sit somewhere and I open the Bible anywhere. God's now going to speak. So I just sit. I don't care whose Bible it is. If you leave it here, you're going to find it full of marks. So I pick it up and I start. Oh, shepra, baba, go. Wow. This is awesome. Wow. Man, that reminds me of another scripture. Yeah, there it is. Wow. Now I remember that. Man, where's that other one, I think? Wow. Yes, there. Whew, thank you. Then I put it down. I don't read a Bible without a pen, because God's going to speak. So the word that I read always finds entrance in me, because I appreciate it as God speaking. I don't take it as a dead letter. I receive it as a life-giving spirit word. If I read it, I appreciate it. That's why our church name is Spirit Word Ministries. Because